Give your all. We're going to spend a lot of time today. Thank you. you know, government has a beautiful opportunity to enjoy a free region.
It's a great country.
So we're going to talk some more about that along the way. But one of the most exciting, I mean, just think, tingle down your spine moment of the entire air show is about to happen. And that's known as the wind drift indicator. So, this red line is...
We're here to let the next generation
So while we're out here today, in there, and I tell you one of the things that I
now
we'll be right back.
Thank you. Father Alfred is receiving the Good Conduct Medal, Asiatic Pacific Campaign Medal with two Bronze Stars, World War II Victory Medal, and additional medals for Alfred's valiant service during World War II. Thank you. A huge thank you for the inspiration. I think, Dr. Novella, you're close to $1 billion in assistance for our veterans in need. So you're doing amazing things. And we can have the family of William Rowe come forward. William's son's gonna be coming forward to receive medals. This is one of the ones that we started 2 years ago, and through the process with NPRC closing down, this is an absolute honor to be presenting him his medals. He's receiving the Good Conduct Medal, European African Middle Eastern Campaign Medal with three Bronze Stars, World War II Victory Medal, and combat infantry badge for William's gallant service in World War II. Corey Smith here. No, he didn't get a chance to check in. Corey here. The next family I'd like to recognize is the family of Paul Dziak, but it's actually the family of Paul Dziak, William Cham, and Emil Billy. So we've done a number of requests for the Billy family. Uncle Paul was a volunteer at the Ohio Western Reserve Cemetery for a number of years, putting in thousands of hours to his fellow service members. First, they're receiving the medals for Paul. Who's received the Purple Heart American Campaign Medal, Asiatic Pacific Campaign Medal, World War II Victory Medal, and additional medals for his service during World War II. Along with that, their parents, William and Emil, whose records are still being evaluated, are both receiving the World War II Victory Medal. One of the unique things about World War II mariners, those that served in the Merchant Marine, is they can receive a DD-214 for their service, but they have to apply for that. And that's one of the things we are doing with the Billy family, is getting him his DD-214 that's 70 years, actually now almost 80 years past due. So we're able to provide that for them along with their medals. So thank you. And if I could please have Victoria come to the stage. So this is outstanding because Victoria Assort serves on the Medina County Veterans Service Commission Board, along with Ed Zachary here. Actually, Ed, you work for Victoria.
I do.
She's a modern era veteran that has served, and she's going to be doing a special presentation for Wayne Miller. Wayne, if you can come up here, a Vietnam veteran. It's always an honor when we have a son or a daughter, in this case a daughter, who served presenting medals to her father, the Vietnam Service Medal, the Vietnam Campaign Medal, and welcoming her father home from Vietnam. So, welcome home, Wayne. Welcome. Thank you. As we're concluding our medal ceremony, one of the important things to note is that if you have a loved one who is owed military medals or ribbons or service documentations, you can request that. So any next of kin can request the medals for their service members. So if you are the son, daughter of a World War II veteran or Vietnam veteran, and you ever had curiosity of what your father, your mother, that hero in your life did, you're able to file requests through any of the County Veterans Service Commission offices, either Medina County Veterans Service Commission, Cuyahoga County, Stark County, or you can go on the website of the National Personnel Records Center and file the request yourself, so that you'll be able to get that documentation for your loved one's life and service. So definitely we'd like to thank all of those heroes. If those heroes can stand up for one more second so that we can recognize you. If you're able to come up front here, just for kind of a, we're going to do a group photo just to kind of say thank you. And then we're going to be moving into recognizing some individuals who are joining military service here in a minute. They're actually going to be enlisting in the United States Air Force. So as they're getting on, if you can just give us a few moments as they're getting ready for that as well.
So ladies and gentlemen, once again, we want a big round of applause all across the grounds for all of our military service members. This group of outstanding families up here representing World War II, Vietnam, and current day military. We thank you so much for your service. Thank you for your family and friends' service. And now for our young people who are about to enlist into the Air Force. We're actually running a few minutes early, so we're gonna give them time to get their families over to the A-10. And so at this point, if you are part of our group that's being enlisted, we would ask you and your family to make your way towards the A-10s, and we'll get set up for that ceremony. In the meantime, we're gonna let you spend those days Air Force, but to enlist at an air show with an A-10 demo team pilot doing the oath of enlistment. For some of us, when we enlisted, we had to stand in a little office of the Cleveland MEPS facility, so this is definitely cool. Congratulations to all of you. Thank you, mom and dad, to raise the children who are willing to join us on all volunteer force to help protect their country. Congratulations to you as well. And so with that, I will turn it over to Major Pullum. Gator, it's all yours.
Awesome, thanks, Dave. Hey, how's everybody doing? My name is Major Hayden Pullum. I go by Gator. I'm the commander and the pilot of the United States Air Force's A-10 demonstration team, which is this awesome airplane right here behind me that we're going to be flying for you here this afternoon. One of the awesome privileges of being an officer in the military is I get the unique opportunity to come out to places like this and issue the oath of enlistment to our future airmen, which is exactly what we're going to do today. So this is a really exciting time to have them out here, to have their families out here, and be able to experience some of this together. That's important at all. Yeah, so it's a wonderful opportunity to be out here to share this with you, and it's a wonderful opportunity of mine, and I take a lot of pride in being able to do that. So I encourage you, once we're complete with the oath of enlistment, everybody obviously give them a big round of applause for their dedicated service to this country, and then we'll, of course, have the opportunity to bring families down and get some pictures and things like that. So we will not take any longer than we need to. We'll jump right to it. All right, everybody, if you come to the position of attention, raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name.
I, Jeremy.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
Against all enemies, foreign and domestic.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same.
That I will obey the orders of the President of the United States. And of the officers appointed over me, in accordance with regulation and the Uniform Code of Military Justice. So help me God. Give him a round of applause. Thank you.
Notably, the cockpit is all in a spring ringer.
Sits in the front.
Now we're going to get Jeffrey back on the ground here momentarily as he's lining up at the end of the runway.
Parking area. The engine is turned on. So the purpose of the wind drift indicator, as we were talking about earlier today, the parachutes that these folks are flying are actually basically an inflatable wing. So they are going to be able to steer themselves into their target area. But what we have to do is make sure that we know for sure what's happening at different levels. Because what you're feeling on the ground could be completely different at altitude. And so sometimes it can be drastically different. Other, it can just be the same. So it's really kind of weird. It all depends on what Mother Nature's throwing at us at the moment.
Thank you.
So in the formation of 34s, there's two Air Force T-34s, two Navy T-34s, all used and trained by the U.S. military. Thank you. this line, and they decided not to break. So as I come by, we give you one more time the circuit board. Pilots?
Right down there in the target area.
Now your watch here is going to flare that load, you just saw him break a little bit.
Thank you.
Our team would appreciate it if you took any pictures and video of him in the aircraft this weekend. That you share them on all of our social media. He's up on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, SwampBox, C51.
Thank you.
So, the members of the weekend administration team and George was just at a very good point last night. We're sure we're having our product here today. We're not sure if the audience is quite ready for the weekend administration team, so we're going to give them another minute. But why don't we rip back on the ground? We're getting our team fueled up, and then we're going to turn it over to the HK. We wanted to point out a couple other groups of people that we really need to thank. Standing out here on the deck with us, all down some of our content. And before we turn into the airstream show, we would like to once again thank Megan, Aircraft Breaking System. Megan, an able to join her to fly, to power up the wheel, and she's not hiring right in the engine, to power up the wheel.
Now, from the city, here, Thank you. Thank you. right here, it will rip that quick.
Yeah, there's nothing in it. Like, I bet you it gets off the ground.
I want to see that.
I could be wrong. They brought the stairs up, but they got the APU running.
Thank you.
He's got a Moab in the back of that.
John Abrams just lined on the back of the parachute. You know, my uncle flew C-5s, and they would do that. They would fly really close to the ground and slide a tank on the back. And a parachute and grab it and take it out.
Because I see you put a thing in there that gave one. It was just the impression you were...
Slam it! Aircraft carrier!
Oh wait, they're probably gonna do like that.
We would have to be American. Oh.
Best time to be doing touch and goes.
It looks like he's gonna have to go around and come back.
Will